Halo to you all, today gue akan nge-review salah satu mobil yang spesial banget untuk gue, seperti Glory yang kemarin. Ini salah satu dream car gue yang gue suka banget ya. So yeah, a brief history of this car. This is a Nissan Skyline GT-R BNR32 untuk base modelnya, diproduksi dari tahun 1989 sampai 1994. So yang kita nge-review sekarang itu the base model lah. The R32 GT-R has the engine we all know and love too, the RB26 DETT. There are 5 trim levels untuk GTR ini, the base model, the GTR Nismo, the V-Spec 2, and the V-Spec, and the N1. Naganori Ito was also the designer of the R32 GTR, jadi plan dia tuh is to make the R32 more competitive than the R31 GTSR di Touring Car Championship kategori Group A. Salah satu fitur unik lagi ya dari R32 is that it has an all-wheel drive torque split system called the ATESA. The purpose of the ATESA is supaya mobilnya nggak gampang understeer or oversteer while at corners gitu. Fun fact, this car also won 29 races from 29 starts across 4 seasons in the Japan Touring Car Championship. So ya, agak winning ya ini mobil. Lumayan kenceng berarti ini. In the Australian Touring Car Championship 2, mobil ini juga dominan dari tahun 90 sampai 92. So yeah, we're gonna start with the box packaging now. The box packaging menurut gue udah cakep banget personally. I really like the matte finishing on the box gitu. Enak gitu rasanya enak gitu ya kalau dipegang gitu. And it looks good juga tuh from when it's under light. The HPI Racing text art also looks awesome gitu. Gue juga suka banget sama finishing warna silvernya ya, because it really stands out from the black color. Moving on to the protector, mobil ini juga udah dilindung sama akrilik ya, so it's safe. In the base of the car, itu ada silver plate juga yang kasih tahu model mobilnya tuh apa gitu ya. So yeah, it's really cool, I really like that finishing right there. Note too that this car isn't too new pas gue beli ya, jadi emang kalau ada fading di teksnya masih wajar lah, because finding a sealed model is not really easy too untuk HPI yang gini. So yeah, we're gonna take a closer look to the casting itself. Note itu gue taruh silika gel supaya nggak lembab, karena kan kalau lembab tuh biasa catnya bisa merintis gitu, and that's a big no-no for me because that ruins the paint and yeah, you know what happens next. The casting is made by HPI Racing from 2009 until 2010, jadi tuh ini in 1:43 scale ya, jadi materialnya tuh juga metal bahannya, and which makes this die cast. So even though HPI tuh they're specialized in RC, modelnya tuh juga scale modelnya itu juga biasanya cakep banget semuanya. Their scale models from yang gue liat tuh semuanya flawless. They're also priced at a premium, jadi pas gue beli ini this was like 700,000 rupiah. So yeah, lama banget nabungnya pas mau beli ini, tapi emang worth it banget untuk gue sih. Even though HPI mahal banget, remember premium price pasti premium details kita dapetnya. So this is not just flawless, tapi no, I think it's just flawless seriusan. Like there are no mold lines or rough paint or anything that I can call and spot a flaw. Gila sih ini emang, I'm just blown away looking at this model right now. So yeah, we're gonna go to the small details now. So small details such as the badges, itu emang udah kelihatan real banget. Jadi mirip kayak mobil aslinya ya. Jadi badge-nya tuh dari chrome and ditempel ke body mobilnya gitu. So it's just like the real thing. So you can see like the badge sticks out of the trunk gitu. Really cool. Since other companies usually or other models kan biasa kan cuman dibuat dari stiker doang atau enggak tampo gitu ya. So yeah, I really like this one. This one's awesome. The front Skyline badge juga spot on banget ya, kelihatan tuh banget dari detailnya. Even though it's small, you can see like the detail of the depth of the Skyline badge gitu. Emang the sizing of the badge itu juga udah bener juga. So yeah, I have no problems with this car so far. Headlight sama taillightnya juga bagus banget ya. It's just like the real thing in terms of the level of details. Another note, kalau kita lebih lihat deket ke headlightnya, you can see there are black outlines which are like the real lights in the real R32s. The brake calipers are also just mesmerizing untuk dilihat, like the brakes. It's just so awesome gitu, the level of detail put into the remnya doang ya, untuk brake calipers doang itu just mind blowing gitu. Take a look at the stock exhaust juga, itu juga mirip banget kayak aslinya tuh ya. The paint is also so spot on, as I said before there are no rough spots or anything, but biasanya kadang tuh emang ada problem biasanya in terms of old diecast tuh emang biasanya tuh bakal ada merintis atau bakal ada cat lecet, but so far here I don't find any problems at all. So yeah, kayak aslinya ya, the gun gray metallic tuh udah I'm not sure if I can say kayak asli ya, because I've never seen a gun gray Bien Artery 2 in person, tapi overall I really like the gray color, it's really cool. Emang metallic flake-nya juga ada di situ, so yeah, really awesome. So right now, this is the point where I will try to find, ada kekurangan gak ya di casting ini? Overall, I just can't see anything to call it a flaw, yeah. Like I said before, it's just so flawless. Seriously, like, the proportion of this car is just so accurate, like, the level of detail in a 1 out of 43 scale in this R32 is just mind-blowing. Gila deh, like, gue gak pernah ngemegang casting tuh yang perfect banget di tangan gue, di mata gue, literally, like, it's just mind-blowing. Awesome banget sih ini. Pas pertama kali gue lihat aja langsung ya, I was also in shock because I didn't know, like, it's, like, the level of quality, the quality control tuh udah pasti ketat banget, pasti. The paint pas gue lihat pertama kali gitu, I put it under the sun, it shines brightly, you know, the metallic flakes juga emang ada shiningnya gitu, really good depth of color juga. Personally, gue juga suka banget sih ini. It's just mind blowing again if I have to say it. So yeah, right now I'm just gonna talk about who should buy these stuff gitu, like target audience itu siapa untuk produk HPI Racing gini yang which is this flawless and this mind blowing gitu. So yeah, it's just really mind-blowing. I just can't stop complimenting about it, sorry. Right now, we're gonna talk about, like, what the goal of HPI is, gitu. So HPI itu emang jarang ya bikin models, not jarang bikin model scale, tapi jarang di spotlight, gitu, model scale. Because mereka tuh, if you go to their website or anything, they showcase usually their RCs. So their goal for this precision cast model, as they say, is to replicate like seakurat mungkin gitu, without compromise or anything gitu, and it really shows in this car gitu. So yeah, I think personally the price maybe is the problem. Enggak juga sih, because the price is sudah gila juga sih untuk 700.000. I paid for 700,000 and detail level detailnya kayak gini, so I'm not really mad gitu ya. But I think personally, due to the price of the product too, gue juga nggak ngerekomend kolektor baru untuk nyoba. So yeah. Products like this itu lebih cocok untuk market yang udah berpengalaman and mereka udah tahu bagaimana ngejaga scale model mereka gitu. Finding HPIs itu juga agak susah ya untuk yang 1:43 di Indo, because di Tokped I can only find 5 examples and they're the same car gitu. All 4 were GTRs, R32 GTRs, and one was a Volvo 850R. So yeah, the pricing is also from 575,000 itu untuk rupiah ya, sampai 700.000 rupiah juga. Itu juga tergantung condition-nya of the car. So because these prices are normal for HPI, before buying lebih bagus lu tanyain dulu kondisinya and cek catnya di mobilnya. Probably your best bet to find an HPI model you want or this exact one is through eBay, because yeah, emang like it or not, emang lebih bagus sih international shipping because it's more broad gitu kan. Or you have to go to a convention and find one of these, tapi kan ya, in times like now there is no such thing as conventions anymore, and yeah, even though kita langsung nyari ya physically ya, itu juga belum tentu ketemu juga. So yeah, we're gonna jump into the conclusion now. So if I'll be honest ya, it kind of scares me that ini serem banget sih ya. For me ya, it kind of serem banget because tuh castingnya and the level of detail tuh flawless banget ya untuk. This is 1 out of 43 ya, just to remind you guys again, it's not 1 out of 18, it's 1:43, gila sih. For the rating wise, I gave it a 10 out of 10 because I couldn't find any flaw or anything. It just keeps on impressing me, you know, every time I look at it, every time I put it under the light, every time I take a photo of it. So yeah, the accuracy is just on point, so far gak ada flaw sama sekali. Well, probably the only flaw is the normal price for HPI, probably yeah, 700,000, 575,000. Thousands, yeah, in that area lah. So if I have to choose untuk 1:43 model favorit gua, it's probably this one, because every time I just look at this car, it yeah, blows my mind again. I said it 1,000 times, tapi beneran sih, like you have to see it for yourself. So yeah, thank you for watching this review actually. Thank you for listening to me being excited about reviewing this R32 GTR. Go ahead and subscribe, go ahead and like the video too, share the video to your friends if they plan to buy an HPI model, or maybe this exact model if they want to buy it. So yeah, thank you very much.